She does not know what LOL means. How did dog hair get on this? Alright, they're in here somewhere. Here we go, okay. Skills, no, none of those. No. Although that one has come in handy. That's a funny one. Here it is. How am I supposed to relearn this? Oh. Right.
No, it's the video file, the one labeled Wood Guy. There.
And Wood. Yes, Wood! As it was preached by Joshua. Wood. You shall follow and use wood to build your temples. Wood. Yes, wood. That's what determines your life. It is surrounded of brown wood. Now repent, sinners, and go build out of wood.
Also, you're investigating him, not me.
What?
Management wants an analysis of this wood freak by the end of the week. If you don't have it...
Damn!
But this is your find. You're the one that found the Yelp page and browsing for cheap apartments.
Yeah, but I told him you found it, so...
Pencil, come on.
You know, it's kind of funny how your office just looks like you sit around and play video games all day.
Okay, fine. Why do they care about this guy? What do they want to know?
Look, I don't know. They just told me that he showed up with some community home and a billion comments, and they probably just want to make sure that he's not some harem house scheme. I don't know. I didn't ask for details.
Why didn't you ask more questions?
Not my problem.
But...
just have it done by the end of the week.
This is the last time I'm doing anything for you.
End of the week, Nutella.
End of the week, huh? What luck. Well, if I don't want to be standing before the director without anything to show.
Just for pleasure!
I better get digging.
Yes, put it in many uses no matter what the hell you want to use, whatever you want to use it for.
This is Bruce Altman. Subject 1. Wood Guy. The video surveillance I've been given shows a canvas of his life through his years.
That was legitimate.
My personal opinion of his character to follow upon conclusion.
Whoa.
My analysis begins at the root of this assignment.
Crazy.
The Yelp reviews.
Oh, no!
They are a mixed bag, to say the least. Let's go through some of them.
I stayed at the Orphan Retirement Community during the COVID pandemic. It was overbooked and I was forced to sleep in the attic with a portable AC unit that would go out. The only activities they had available were badminton and the board game Clue. What's even worse is that there is only one bathroom. I was forced to pee outside in the middle of the night surrounded by coyotes. 10/10 would recommend due to low cost.
The property is beautiful, but the groundkeeper, Bruce, starts too early in the morning. Many mornings during my stay, I was awoken to the sound of the lawnmower outside my window.
How do you pronounce this place?
Authentic Mint.
There are always so many people there. They had to build an extension to the porch for the overflow. People come in without knocking and show up at all hours of the day or night. Introverts, hell.
I've spent a few nights at the Orthman Retirement Community. The hosts, Julie and Bruce, are great. There's always an endless supply of hummus and wine. Julie is such an attentive host and constantly asks hummus. Anyone want hummus? Drink? Can I make you a drink? so thoughtful. Bruce is outgoing and knows how to keep the party going. He's also the best pizza chef there is. 10/10 recommend Pop's Pizza. The only downfall is that my husband has to sleep on the sofa since there is only one twin-sized bed.
The Othmant Retirement Community is a great place to host your next party. The owners, Bruce and Julie, are so accommodating. They even turned their garage into an event hall after unexpected rainfall during one of our celebrations. Bruce is also an excellent grill master and accommodates food allergies. The best sous vide steak we've ever had, don't tell his son we said that.
10 out of 10. Loved playing the badminton here during the summer.
1 out of 10. No more fresh organic chicken eggs. The owners got rid of the chicken coop. I'm so disappointed. This place is going downhill. I'm used to eating 4 organic eggs every day.
I have come across some footage that shows he has a history of procuring animals. It is here where he lures the birds in close, so his accomplice can strike it in an attempt to scavenge a meal.
Oh, I now hit his butt!
Though he has been seen to be extremely protective of animals, as shown here as he just sits motionless in the ocean holding a dog. This particular video could be indicative of something else, as this anonymous Yelper states.
I think the owner, Bruce, is having a midlife crisis. He bought an electric golf cart and now trying to sell it for an absurd $5,000. Scam artist here, beware.
In an attempt to validate some of these claims, I paid a brief visit to one of our oldest secret agents from the force, Agent Van Jenkins. As you're aware, he was undercover in the Altman family for years before he stepped down to accept an exceptional care package offered at the retirement community under question. If it seems like a conflict of interest, that's because it is.
Well, I've always been impressed with things he said and things he did and how he went about doing them. I mean, the best way I can explain it is I've been impressed with Bruce and still am.
A nod of approval from the vet.
That's the best way I can explain it.
Let's see what other reviews have to say.
One of out 10. Swing set has been under construction for over a year. At one point, there was big plans to finish it. What happened?
10 out of 10. The fire pit and making s'mores are the highlight to my fall.
The attic is huge and storage is free. Would recommend.
Nice and home gym, but there's dust on the bike.
Love the golf cart rides down the road. There is a particularly beautiful and well-manicured house on Reeves Drive that you get to drive by. No weeds or anything in the yard. Disappointed to hear they may be doing away with this service.
The property is so pretty. Lots of farmland and well-maintained by the owner, Bruce. Do I all have an extra residence available at the Ultimate Retirement Community? Looking to move soon since our family is leaving us behind. Green Thumb Gardener included.
10 out of 10. Decor is always stunning. During Christmas, I feel like I'm in a winter wonderland. Great job decorating the property, Bruce.
He does have a track record of decorating for holidays. Even some CCTV footage of him pretending to be Santa exists. He seems to be just a big kid himself, though sometimes torturing other kids for his own entertainment.
You ready to get on with your daddy? You ready to walk with daddy? Okay, let's see you walk to your daddy. Come here, Michael. Hey, walk to your daddy. Go see your daddy.
Skip it about him, daddy.
He has also showcased himself a leader, both in the community as a councilman and in the home as a Boy Scout troop leader.
My mind.
Nick! This is a wonderful place, very attentive to everyone's needs. Even if they're out of hummus or anything else the clients may need, they make a special trip to the store to get it for me.
The condiments are all expired, but there's always hummus and soft drinks readily available. Pick your battles, I guess.
Good variety of snacks, including chocolate-covered almonds. If the owner likes you, he will take you to get frozen yogurt and buy you PJ's coffee in the morning. Definitely worth getting on his good side, .. Actually, I think he will do it, even if he didn't like you. Guys, too nice. A little sis, if you ask me.
Nice place to send your folks to in their old age. A lot of new additions to the facility, including outdoor seating area with big screen TV, BBQ facilities, pizza oven, and fire pit. Makes you wonder how they get rid of the old folks once they expire. Nurse Julie on staff seems nice and accommodating. Owner Bruce seems a bit sketchy. Have heard occasional gunfire out back of the facility. Recommend the facility only if you don't care about your inheritance, as these folks are bound to take it.
The facility is too welcoming. Clean, homely, and the guy next door is very quiet at times. It's overly suspicious. The area is surrounded by nature and walking paths to clear the mind and smell the fresh air. It's not too far away from the city, but far enough where you don't hear any loud city noises. Oddly too good of a spot. Again, feel like they are hiding something. The staff are too nice. friendly and accommodating. Whenever I visit, I'm always welcome to food and lovely time. The main staffer, Bruce, goes too much out of his way make me feel at home. His homemade pizza oven is able to craft some fresh homemade pizzas and always seems to put a smile on people's faces. Again, I think he is hiding something with that pizza oven. Seems like a good spot to destroy evidence if you ask me. Overall, if you are looking for 5/5-star experience, that is the place to go, but I'm not falling for the deception. The place is too lovely and the staff, especially Bruce, is too nice. He will go out of his way to make you feel welcome and feel the joy of a loving family.
Seeing this, I found and interviewed two folks who are soon to be settling in at the retirement community. They have known Bruce for a long time. Their candor was enlightening.
We're going to tell the truth about Bruce, aren't we?
I am looking forward to move with my middle child, because he's the only person offered to take me.
Well, let's talk about that. We're getting out of our subdivision because of the HMO, and he's already committed. Once we committed, he's got telling me about his rules about his HMO,
which we're not, like. We're not going to follow since we're the parents. Good thing for Julie, she's in charge.
Julie is the one in charge. Julie,
she has really helped us a lot.
Keep them together.
And she keeps Bruce a little cool because now she corrects him like I should have been doing.
No, Bruce, hard worker. I got to say the truth about
him. Very hard worker.
Hard worker.
We love him very much.
If you need him for anything, like Nick falling through a ceiling, you know, repairs tomorrow, he's right there, Johnny on the spot, you know, looking after all his kids.
He's on the spot.
He's a good dad. I got to say that, you know. But he talked to me about my house being built in front of that pool. And it's a good spot. And that's the reason he put his pool there, so when everybody has to go to the bathroom, they come to my house. And I told him, I'm putting a quarter toilet on the door. 25 cents to use the toilet, and you got 1 minute to pee, or the door flies open.
Bad word. He don't know how to say toilet. Toilet!
So I'm sure they'll come up with other rules, you know.
Okay. We love you, Bruce.
You take care, buddy. Enjoyed
it. Looking forward to seeing you at our new pool house.
In summation, this Bruce guy seems like one of the good ones. While there are some suspicious reviews out there, the videos, interviews, and even some personal encounters with him have all shown nothing but positivity. Bruce really does appear to be an upstanding man who has loved his family, worked hard to accomplish his goals, and has never shied away from being a mentor when called upon.
Very good.
In a short word, he's an awesome person. Even if future archivists who stumble upon his video footage may find themselves a bit puzzled.
Inspector Nutella.
What the?
We have reviewed your report. While we feel you did your best, you also overlooked an important detail.
I'm sorry, Director, I didn't have enough time.
If you want to remain active, then we really need you to close out this case.
Of course, I'll do anything.
There's a party at the Four Deuces this weekend, and you're invited. The only intel we have is some old surveillance footage of a similar event.
This is our murder mystery.
This weekend, though, Bruce is masquerading under his better-known alias. The mob boss, Big Jim Ravioli. It's your job to get in there and verify your findings. And Nutella, don't screw this up.
Oh, don't you worry. What could go wrong?